again YouTube, Mad Dog here. Welcome back to my channel. Just wanted to do a bit of a video on something we're all very familiar with, which is the old survival tin, just in case tin, whatever you want to call it. Hope you guys and lasses have all got one and carry one. If you don't carry it, you'll never use it. But this is something, a little bit of a twist on this subject. Let's suppose really we should be religious about carrying these things when you go out and about, or anywhere really. But you know, for the times when you don't, you leave it at home, you forget it, you lose it, you drop it, whatever. So that's it, you've had to dump your kit for whatever reason. You've got basically what you're wearing. So you know, this is where this little hack comes in. So all I've got now is my fat belly to rely on, my cargo pants, my belt, my t-shirt. I'll take you into the shed now, show you a little trick, a little deviation on this theory. See what you all think. Stay tuned. Alrighty, welcome back. So obviously back in the dreaded shed. So basically I'm back in here just to give you a quick look around this little fella. Excuse me while I just pan down here. So obviously, like I said earlier, cargo pants and a belt. So what I'm going to do now is I'm just going to whip my belt off, get it on the old bench here, lay it out and show you the little twist on the survival tin. And open it up, show you the contents, because I guess you all know where this is going anyway. And we'll have a look what I carry inside there. Show you a few variations and some options. We'll discuss a few options and I'd like some feedback off you guys and lasses. Let me all know what you think and see how we get on. Stay with me. Okay, I've taken my belt off, laid it across the bench here just so you can have a quick look around this thing. So it's a black nylon belt, as you can see, with a simple, you know, one of these simple plastic push lock systems here. Dead simple, dead basic, adjustable. It's only about an inch in width, so that's the belt. But the secret is we all know, I guess you guys and lasses know this anyway, but if you turn it onto the inside, there is a zipper which runs the full length of the belt. So basically you've got a hidden compartment within the belt. Now these things, they're marketed to people like tourists that if you want to hide some money on your person or documents or keys or whatever, you can, you know, conceal them within your belt, wear it, and if you're robbed or, you know, whatever, for whatever reason, you've still got something on you that you've concealed. So my version of things with this is, you know, use it as a emergency survival tin kit as well as. So we're going to zip this up and I'll show you all the contents, if I can, of what I've got in here. Now, I'm not going to lie to you, there isn't much room and everything has to be packed with some order and some patience, let's say. So I've opened it up and you can see I've got quite a few various items in here. So I'll take them out one at a time, give you a quick look round, and also throw in a couple of extra options as well as we go along. So starting at this end, I think there was actually about 25 feet of waxed bank line cordage in there. Now each item I've put in a small Ziploc bag and taped the item and the end of the bag. This makes it easier to get it into the belt for storage. Otherwise, when you come to close it up with a zip, you have it all on hell of a time to get it in. Everything gets snowed up. So that keeps it waterproof and usable, basically. So a bit of cordage. Then here I've got some meds in this little compartment. I've got my antihistamines, because I do suffer hay fever, and I've got some aspirin, which all obviously always useful in case of heart attack, you or somebody else, and painkiller. And I think I've got some codeine pain relief in there as well. Moving on, I have some of my magnesium tinder, fire starting tinder there, and I have some fatwood shavings with a bit of Meyer dust in there as well. Again, obviously, fire tinder. Moving along the belt, in here I have two of the party type candles. You know, you blow them out and they relight for windy conditions. A good piece of aluminium foil, which can be used to collect water boil water, signal, all sorts of uses, a bit of tin foil. And also wrapped inside of there is a couple of Stanley knife blades, small scalpel blades rather, because you've got to be careful how you store blades, obviously in a belt that you're going to wear around your waist, so potentially you could get injured from your own making. So be careful what you do put in these things. And the legality side of it, be careful what you wear, you know. Don't wear something like this through an airport tour, you know, you get the picture. And because I've been limited for room and space, I've packed one of these little fellas. I've shown these many times before. It's one of my homemade flat folding tin can whistles, if you like. Emergency whistle made out of a pop can or something like that. So we get it out and fold it and pinch the two sides together. I think I've actually, in my very early days, made a video on how to make these things. Dead easy to make. Pinch that together somewhat. So as you can see, quite an effective little whistle, just out of a pop can, beer can, whatever. Moving on, a boo-boo kit. Basic first aid kit. Couple of plasters. fake stitches, alcohol wipes, etc, etc. I'm just whipping through this because you know all this stuff anyway, but I'm just showing you the basic amount of stuff that you can get in a small belt. So obviously a ferrocerium rod and a hacksaw blade striker at least. for me, the most trustworthy form of fire lighting in an emergency. And obviously, being a hacksaw blade, you've got the added bonus that you can actually cut things with the serrations, you know, the toothed edge. So that's a no-brainer for me. And then a compass, a mini button compass. Now these, you either love them or hate them. And I fall into two camps with this. If the cheap, nasty ones, I hate them and I think they're dangerous and you shouldn't really even waste your time and money with them. If the good ones, then something is better than nothing if it's reliable. Excuse me out of frame here a moment. I'm just looking for this little fella. So you really want to invest in something like this, which is the marbles version. Yes, they are more money. For the price of one of these, you would get 20 of these from China, but you'll get 20 rubbish ones. Waste of time, one good one. End of. Get yourself a good one if you're going to go down that route. Moving on. A small, you know, one of these little keyring type LED lights. You know, something's better than nothing. And check your preps. If you've had this kit for a long time, periodically check that these things still work. I actually started to experiment with some stick-on Velcro down here, but you know, there weren't enough room. So some water purification tablets, each tablet for a litre of water obviously, and I think I've got six there. And then adding on to that theme, a couple of water collection bags. So, you know, I've got 2 litres of water collection there. So at the moment, that's all I'm carrying. So basically, I've covered fire, signalling, because don't forget, you're not doing an escape and evasion. I'm not anyway, not these days. so it's not about that. It's about a basic survival kit. So to cover fire, water, you've got, if you've got the basic training and knowledge, you can make your own shelter. You've got cordage, again, for fire emergencies. You've got basic first aid, and most importantly, signalling. In a bad situation, you want to be seen and heard and get rescued. So you've covered them basics with basically what you're wearing on a belt. Now, obviously, that being said, you could swap some of these items out for, let's say, a fishing kit. If you're inland, I don't know, you know, if you're by the coast or by waterways, rivers, yeah, why not? You could swap it out, add some money. It's a survival belt. You know, money, you can buy things with money. Don't make life hard work. It's about getting yourself home. It's not about being, you know, like a Rambo character. It's about getting yourself home, back to your family safe. That's what these things are for. There's a whole wide variety of small items that you could add into these little things. I mean, I dare say the standard 2-inch belt webbing, you'd probably get two of these side by side or on top of each other. So, you know, experiment, see what you know, find works for you. These were a couple of pounds, about £2.50 off the internet, this belt, by the way. And I just thought I'd share this one. It's a different take on the survival tin, which, let's be honest, we all probably have left home without it. I do. You know, I've got one in my vehicle. In fact, I've got two in my vehicle, one in every one of my outdoor jackets and a standard sort of go-to kit. But just knocking about the local side streets, I don't really carry. So this would be a good option for me to wear on my trousers and forget about. And I've always got something. Something is always better than nothing, in my opinion. Apart from these. Apart from a rubbish compass. That's just going to get you deeper in trouble. Don't go there. Buy a good one. Or not at all. Learn to navigate using the sun, the stars, the moon. Whatever it takes. You know, magnetise a needle on a, in a puddle on a leaf. But don't trust these. They're bloody rubbish. Anyway, I digress. So anyway, hope you find some of this useful. Maybe give you a few ideas of stuff to try yourself. Let me know what you all think below. And I'll see you soon on the next one. Have a great weekend out there. Take care. Mad Dog signing off. Yeah! Ah, shit. I've got to get all this gear back in this thing now. Deep joy.